All right, welcome to the second tutorial in our Simple Microcontroller series, where we're going to show you how to do some pretty awesome things with the most basic microcontrollers possible and learn a ton of cool stuff while we're doing it. So in this video, we're just going to go over what we need. Basically, as you can see here, there's going to be some hardware and there's also going to be some software needed to do this successfully. So first thing that we need is, of course, the microcontroller. So we are using the PIC10F200, and you can get that from any authorized distributor, online components, DigiKey, Mouser, whatever. You can also get it from AliExpress, but they're not authorized, so if you get a terrible one, that's going to be up to you. So we recommend going through an authorized distributor whenever possible, and if you're going to be making more than one of these just for your own use, definitely go to an authorized distributor. But yes, the PIC10F200, go get one of those things. They're cheap. Probably want to get a couple of them because they're so cheap, just in case you blow something up in the process. The second thing that you're going to need is a programmer or a debugger. Now, Microchip makes quite a few of these, and there's actually also some other DIY ones that you can make if you want. We're not going to go into that, but that is an option if you're looking at it. There is the PICKit series and the ICD series, and basically they all go from PICKit 2, PICKit 3, PICKit 4, and then the ICD 2, ICD 3, ICD 4. The PICKit 4 and the ICD 4 are the latest ones, and that's what I'm using here. But Sergey, who wrote these tutorials, he actually uses a PICKit 3. And technically, since this is an older microcontroller, you can use a PICKit 2. So if you already have one of those, perfect, you don't need anything. If you are planning on making millions of these things, then you probably want the faster and more robust ICD series, but they're way more expensive. So that's why we're just sticking with the PICKit, because we're only using it for our own tutorials and prototyping and stuff like that. So microcontroller, and then you also need the programmer debugger. And then you're going to need the actual electronic components themselves. So right now I have the first circuit that we're going to use already set up, but you can see the things that we're going to need. We're going to need some jumper cables, male to male and male to female, depending on what tutorial we're on. Right now I'm only using the male to male, but eventually we'll need some male to female jumpers on there. You can see the microcontroller, obviously. We have some 1K and 10K resistors for our LEDs and also to protect the microcontroller with the switches. We have some push button switches, and then I don't have on here, but we'll need eventually, is a piezoelectric buzzer. So once you have those things, you should be good to go. Also, all this stuff is on CircuitBread.com, so if you don't want to be writing notes quickly while I'm talking about this, go to the tutorial that's linked in the description and just see this list so you can go and get exactly what you need to succeed. And finally, the last two things are, one, going to be the computer, and two, the software you're going to run on it. So Sergey runs on a Windows machine, but I have a Mac, and you can run Windows, Mac, Linux, whatever you want, it will work with this. Now, the software, you can use the older MPLAB 8.76, which is a lot smaller than the newest software, the newest IDE, but it still works with this microcontroller, and it's also a little bit more minimal and a little bit more streamlined in certain ways. So Sergey prefers using that, even though he'll use both. However, it is Windows only, and since I run on a Mac machine, I'm using MPLAB X, which is their latest and greatest, which also works with this microcontroller. Also should note that MPLAB X, I believe, only works with the PICKit 4 and doesn't work with the older ones, but the 8.76 works with the older ones. So you need to look at it, see what you currently have, whatever you can do to save money, the PICKit 2 and an old Windows machine you have, and if that's all you need, perfect. And that's it. That's really all the hardware you need, is the computer, these things right here, and then you should be able to move forward. We're going to do a couple of conceptual tutorials, so if you want to order these things right now, if you don't have them already, that'll give you some time to review the next couple of tutorials before we actually set it up and start doing things. But that's it. Hope you found this video interesting and also useful. If you did, please give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you in the next tutorial.